You got it, girl, you got it, girl. You got it, girl, you got it. Little baby in a bag, in a Birkin.
Hey love babes, how you doing? Hope you're doing great. If you're new here, my name is Mukamau. Welcome to another video. So today, as you can see, tunakanika tuko Nairobi National Park. But this is Utawala, guys. This is Utawala. We are heading to a nail parlor. My sister and I and my mom are getting our nails done today. Sisangwa jaifanya nails ever before. Nanajua she's so excited. Asha chagua like the inspiration that she wants, you know, on her nails, and mamangu pia atakuja. So we're heading there tuone if atakuwa able kututengeneza leo. We've left my mom behind, so if he's going to be able to make our nails, sisi wote watatu today, I'm just going to call my mom and tell her to come. So yeah, this is the current state of our fingers. Waonyesha, we'll show you the after. Bye. Hey love them. So I promised you that we're going to show you the after, and here we are. Sijuka ataweza ku acha nitaonyesha vizuri, but nimenunua vitu Lila ananibebea. Let me show you guys. Hizi ndo kucha za Lila. Sijui why the camera is not focusing. Amefanya French. And then here are mine. Mom hajafanywa leo because she had errands in town, but nitampeleka kesho. So yeah. So maybe Leila anaweza tuambia how she's feeling, because this is the first time ever she's getting her nails done. Na amekuwa refu. Nimemwambia kitamramba but hajaniamini. Anyway, waambie.
Hey, nimefurahi na ni smart zimeni bamba tu. You don't know babe. Kiss me slowly, it's the sweetest thing. And it don't change. If I had it my way, you would know that you are. You're the coffee that I need in the morning. You're my sunshine in the rain.
Now when we talk like this, like yeah, what you said is so funny. Like this, like like you must see my nails. Me and my nails are existing together. Period.
If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you love me, won't you?
Hey love babes, how are you doing? Hope you're doing great. I haven't given you updates for like how long. The last time I took up my camera to record or to speak to you guys was actually it was just on Wednesday when I was getting my nails done together with my sister. That was the last time I talked to you guys. And yo, the ghetto. So I'm here to explain everything. As you know, like in the video, we went to get our nails done on Wednesday. Then on Thursday, because my mom had errands to run in town on Wednesday, I had to take her back on Thursday. So my mom got her nails done on Thursday. On Friday, very early in the morning, like 5:30 a.m. guys, I was in the salon getting my hair done. I didn't even show you guys that it was like so early. I didn't miss call of career member I could record. I literally woke up at 5:20. Nikaenda venye nilikuwa because my salonist is around. Nikaanza kushukua 5:30, and we were getting done at around 8. Ikaenda sana 8:20. So yeah, I had to go that early because my salonist was like fully booked, and of course she was going to travel because of, you know, the Christmas thing and the holiday season. So yeah, that's the only time I'm gonna fix. Literally, I wasn't even there. Like, I begged her to do my hair, and she was like, she's fully booked, and I was like, yo, I'm gonna come here even at 3. I just need to get my hair done. And so yeah, we did the 5:30 thing, and here I am. So that was on Friday. On Friday, 5:30 a.m. That's when I got my hair done. And then on Saturday evening, we went to my mom's friend. That's where we spent the Christmas. And yeah, to Lirudi Jana. We just got back yesterday night. So yeah guys, for the pots, the ones that I showed you, I got them at an XUK shop, exactly where I got my plates. If I didn't mention that, like where I got my plates, that's the same place where I got the kettle and the cute mugs. I don't even know whether to call them mugs, but yeah, that's where I got the cute set. Yeah. I think nimewaambia kila kitu. So today is on Wednesday, the 28th of December. Today is on Wednesday, the 28th of December, as I am recording this. And I was going through my goals for 2023, like 28th. So the year is literally over, and I have to now think of 2024. So I was going through my vision board for 2023. I have a digital vision board. I usually make it on Canva. It's on my phone, but I also have like affirmations written down on my notebook. And they're literally one and the same with what is on the vision board. So the vision board is all about pictures. I just put pictures that like represent, like for example, a picture of a camera. That means I want a camera. Picture of, I don't know, I think I'll insert it here in case I don't forget. If I don't forget, I'll insert it here. Yeah, so I usually have the vision board in picture form. That's the digital vision board, and I have affirmations written down on my notebook. I don't even know how to explain it. Like for example, for a camera, I don't just write a camera. I write, I will own a camera. That's how I do the affirmations for the year. Yeah, so I want to go through my 2023 affirmations, my 2023 goals, my 2023 vision board. Yeah. And just get to see how much I've been able to achieve, because the year is literally over. We are going into 2024. So when I have a glimpse of, I want to have a glimpse of things that I achieved and how far I've gotten throughout the year. And if you guys are not new here, you know that I had a tin where I used to put
what are they called? Highlights, exactly. Add a tin. I still have it. I have a tin where I used to put highlights of my week, every single week of the year. So if the math will math, I have to have 52 highlights of the year, because every week I write a highlight of the day, of the week. For days where there are many, I put them all together, you know, to literally, I started doing that to focus on the positives that happen in my life rather than the negatives, because of course life is full of the good and the bad, but I wanted to focus on the good. And you know, for every critic, use it to my advantage. That was literally the goal of the year. So one of the things I did was put affirmations in the tin every single week. I'll go through them with you, of course. So let's go through the affirmations of the year. My affirmations on my vision board of 2023. I wanted to have a skincare routine, and I did that. Of course, I started from like a very low budget, of course, because of my financial status or whatever. Like, I had to buy things that I could afford. And again, if you're not new here, you know very well how much I complained about it, because they weren't really working for me. Of course, sometimes people say that cheap is expensive, but in this case I don't think that it applies. Yeah, it applies for me, but those products, the people who referred me to those products, and they really did well. Like, literally you could see it, the skin was glowing because of those products, but for me it didn't work out, you know. So I wanted a skincare routine, and I literally did that. So a tick on that. I wanted to own a camera. That didn't happen. It didn't happen. So I'm gonna put that in 2024. I wanted to buy a new phone. Instead, I bought two new phone cases and a screen protector. That counts, but I didn't get a new phone. So that also goes to the 2024 goals or vision board. I wanted to read my Bible more, and I did. If you guys remember very well, I got my first Bible recently, and I've been literally reading it. I even wrote like all the books of the Bible and put them in a tin. So I randomly pick a paper, and if the paper, like whatever verse is written on that paper, I read the book, the entire book. Actually, I wrote books of the Bible, so whatever book is written on that piece of paper, I read the entire book, and when I'm done, I pick another random paper. So I have to say I have been reading my Bible even more than I thought I would for this year. So congratulations to me on that. I wanted to save money, and I did that, but how do I put it? It was more of investing rather than saving. So I decided that I just don't want to save without a motive. Like, I just put money, stuck money, you know. So I save for a particular project. Like, if I want a ring light, I save for the ring light, then get the ring light. Then save for another product or another item, buy the item evil. So that's how I did my saving this year. I also wanted to be a better content creator, and I think that I've achieved this because, one, consistency. I think I am more consistent in this channel than I've ever been. Okay, not that I've ever been, because when I started out it was easier. Like, I used to put out content every single week, and school started getting in the way and stuff like that. But I think I have been a better content creator, because of course there's growth in editing, in shooting, in everything. So when I compare 2023 me and 2020 to me, there's a big difference in terms of content creation. So yeah, I wanted to be a better friend, and I have, to the friends that like are in my circle, I have been a better friend to them. I've been listening to them. I've been literally trying to avoid things that piss them off.
I've been writing cute notes because I'm a cute note girly. Thank God, because it has also been reciprocated. The other day, it's not even the other day, it's like a few weeks back, my friend literally wrote me an email and attached a very cute note. That was so cute. Like, that was so cute. I cried. That was so cute. I cried. And I'm really, really grateful for my friends and the fact that they reciprocate the energy that I give, you know. So, yeah. The things that I was able to achieve, I thank God. Also, for the things I was not able to achieve this year, I also thank God. But they'll also be going to my 2024 They'll also be going to my 2024 vision board. Yeah. And one thing about these goals, I have to make them smart. Your objectives have to make sense for them to actually come to life. And what I want to do different next year is plan out for every month. I want to have something to achieve. Like, okay, I will write down all the goals for the year, but for every month I'll also make goals that relate to the goals for the entire year. Get what I'm saying? So that it's easier to achieve the entire list of goals without feeling exhausted or without getting lazy, without even forgetting, because people do write things but end up forgetting that was part of their goals. So yeah, I'm gonna have monthly goals and yearly goals for 2024. That's exactly what I'm gonna do differently. Those who didn't understand what I meant by this is the thing I was talking about. So it has all these pieces of paper. These are the highlights of the year for every single week, and I'm not going to be going through them with you guys today, but definitely another day, because I want to make sure that for all the weeks ziko hapa. So I think nimebakisha ya next week. Yeah, this week. Yeah, this week, because next week Monday ni date one. Ni itakuwa a whole new year. So yeah, let me put zingizime baki, and then probably I'll go through them with you. But this is such a good way. It's so therapeutic to focus on the positives. Like, every positive, you can even do day by day highlights. Like, every highlight of the day, you put it in here. But for me, I chose the whole week, because sometimes nothing is really happening in a day, you know. So please, this I highly recommend this method. Put in all your highlights here. Focus on the good, you know, harness the good from the bad. Literally focus on the positives. It will literally save your mental health, your physical health. Like, it will, I don't even know how to explain it, but this has been a lifesaver in 2023. I really hope I've been of assistance when it comes to planning your vision board. Like I said, I use the digital vision board, where I just go to Canva, pick out a template and use it to plan my vision board. I get all my pictures from Pinterest, so I download from Pinterest, get a template from Canva, and literally do the fixing. And then I also hope that I have been motivational enough for you to start planning for 2024 now. Literally write down your goals for 2024 now and start praying for them. Like, literally start dedicating them to God, start working towards them as early as now. Go make your vision boards, guys. Go start now.
Knew I'd end up with you, baby, we were a match. From day one I was sure that this shit would last. Felt like I was the man, cause I knew that I had you, baby, that was the plan.
The highlights for this day, I'm not even sure you guys will be able to see it, but one of my best friends wrote me a love letter. That's literally what I talked about. She wrote me a love letter and sent it via email. That was the highlight of that week.
you've taught me, info that I said. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
I had a very deep spiritual conversation with my man. Okay, it was the highlight of that week, but well, he's not my man anymore, so that's sad.
Baby, I see how you handle love. You handle patience and you handle pain. That's so amazing. I've loved and I've lost, but you made it back to me. Now look what we got.